Hey everybody, we're back on Minecraft. Real quick, before I start the episode, I'm sick, so if I sound a little congested, that's why. Also, I put myself in a box, not sure why, just giving it a try. But let's just get, you know, right into it. I usually do a bunch of time lapses and things that I've done before in the episodes, but that's boring. I don't feel like doing that. Last episode, I told you guys about the store, and we built the elevator for the store. Well, I built the entire store. Like I said, I have a bunch of footage of, like, time lapse and stuff, but you know what? None of that matters. I don't feel like doing that. So, I'm just gonna go ahead and show you guys the store. Now, there's a few things that I haven't told you, specifically kind of how it's gonna be run. Obviously, I want to pay for things using diamonds, but I want to have something in the middle, right? I don't want to just pay diamonds. So that's why I built this bank here. So what's going to happen is I'm going to be giving the bank diamonds. It's going to give paper in return, which I renamed dollar bills. And using those, I can buy stuff from the store. And obviously, any diamonds that I put into the bank, I can never touch again in my career, obviously. So here is the bank. And I know you guys don't really know what's going on back here, so I'm going to go ahead and show you. Alright, so I'm here in the redstone world. I'll just quickly show you how it works. I put items in this chest here. They go down this hopper. Once it hits this hopper, it triggers a comparator, which stops anything from behind it and forward, which allows this item to be tracked. It goes down here. And then after that, another item comes in. You can see the timings here. So that basically assures only one item is going through the hopper at a time instead of multiple, because then it'll give me multiple signals. And then, since one item is going through, it'll give me one pulse of this, and it'll shoot something up. So, you can see if I put two diamonds, it'll give me one, two items. Alright, cool. Let's go back to the actual world here. And that is literally everything I built. So, there's a chest in here, there's that little redstone circuit, and then all of the items. I put this block here just to kind of signify, you know, it's a weird one. And all diamonds go in here, and like I said, I don't get to touch those diamonds. That's, you know, this is something you guys are going to have to trust me with. And yeah, I already bought, you can see there was already diamonds in there. I've already bought some items. I have $14 left over. These are just dollars that I paid for already and that I can use them. But I'll show you guys just if you're curious. So, and actually I do want to buy something today. So I'm going to go ahead and obviously while I give you the tour of the store, I'm going to be buying some things. So I want, let's just say, you know, I want $10 to spend, right? So I put them in there and then they get counted. And it gives me pieces of paper here. And obviously it goes one by one. And I should get 10 pieces of paper here. Yep, 10 pieces of paper. And yep, so the diamonds are in there. Don't touch them again. And I have my money. And I'll also grab this money for now just because that's money I had extra. So that's basically the entire bank right here. If you go in the back, there's a little bit of decoration. But I really didn't try that hard. And like I said, all of this needs decoration too. But not right now, plus it might be double up. So, let me give you guys a tour of the entire store, because I know, like I said, last episode, we only had the elevator. All this is new. But this is floor one. It's lobby. If we go up, we go to the first section of the store, which is our redstone. So, I didn't build the stores too, you know, magnificent with, like, a lot of colors, because this took me, like, 4 hours in the first place, and I'm a college student. But I did put every single redstone item, everything from, like, you know, honey, slime, dispensers, pistons, sticky, TNT, observers, everything you can imagine as far as redstone goes. And I have the price for everything, you know, laid out right in the front sign, and I have you know, the representation just so I know what's where. And every single one of these chests is filled to a certain amount with all of the items here. So obviously these are things that respawned in, but I can't use them unless I pay for them. That's the secret. So if I want a stack of observers, that's $6. So I get to put out $6, grab a stack of observers, that's mine. There's the cash. And this way, diamonds aren't actually laying in these chests, just the dollars. The diamonds are down in the bank where they belong. So yeah, there's my redstone, and I'll give you guys a tour, or just I'll show you guys each floor. So floor two is redstone. I actually don't have these floors memorized, but I think floor three should be rare items. Yeah, and this is actually the store that I want to go to. End rods. Yes, they're right there. But anyway, I'll show you guys every item that I'm selling. You know, all the ice, quartz, snow, ancient debris. You guys can just look. That's probably something I'm gonna buy. Same with shulker chests and blaze rods, but yeah, ancient debris is pretty expensive, but he's actually what I'm here for. So end rods, 5. I'm going to go ahead and buy 15. So this is basically 15 diamonds. This is represented as 15 diamonds. And I'm going to go ahead and and I get to take 3 stacks. So again, these items aren't cheap. You might think, well, that is 15 diamonds for only 3 stacks of end rods. That is really not a lot. But anyway, it's keep going up, and that's why I'm also not going to be using this store very often, because it is fairly expensive. I made it expensive for myself. Floor 4 is building blocks, so I've had a little bit of expanded storage, since usually I'm going to need more building blocks. Once again, I won't go through each item. I'll let you guys just kind of see. Definitely from this one, the one I'm going to be buying most often is definitely the sea lanterns here. Don't even have enough money to buy one. Then probably the quartz. Alright, let's go to floor 5. I forgot if there's 5 or 6. I think there's 5, but I made a 6th for items that I wanted to add after. So these are bulk blocks. So these are building blocks, but things that have like multiple variations. So wool, concrete, terracotta, things like that. So we got all of our dyes here in a nice little area. Got all the woods, got all of the concrete, all the wool, all the terracotta, and then all the saplings. Once again, you can see all the prices and stuff. I don't need anything from here right now. I might come here to buy wood sometimes, and especially concrete, but I have a wood farm, so I technically won't need them anyway. And then last floor here, floor 6, is random. These are actually things, did I leave anything here? Just things that, you know, there's still some empty stalls that I thought of that I should probably have. So a lot of the nether, basically a lot of the nether stuff here, right? So the nether woods, the glowstone, and some of the things that I forgot. But that is the entire
store. So is every item in here?
No. But what I tried to do is the base items, right? So I'm not going to put glowstone dust and glowstone in here. I'm just going to put glowstone. I'm not going to put fences and doors and trap chests. I'm not going to put any of that because I just put wood and then I could craft it myself. Anyway, guys, so that is the entire store. It took, like I said, it took quite a bit, mostly just because I had to fill every single chest with the items. And then it didn't take that long to figure out the wiring on here, but I'm kind of dumb, so it did take quite a while. Now I'm gonna move this somewhere to like my own personal ATM or something, but for now, those are my leftover dollars. And like I said, all my diamonds go in there and they chill. I think this is something that I definitely needed, just kind of for my own health. As much as I love Minecraft, sometimes going for specific things can get really annoying, and those are the aspects of multiplayer that I want, but obviously I don't do multiplayer, so I think this is a good, fair, and balanced way to do it. But enough about the store. I've got a few updates, but there's one gigantic thing that I did that you guys might find extremely boring, but it's actually extremely important for the series. Okay, guys, so long story short, I was in the end, which I'm going to show you guys in a little bit because I did a little bit of work, and I fell into the void and I lost an entire set of netherite armor and tools, and that made me kind of sad. And I went back for my spare and I was like, I actually don't have a spare. So, you know, I got a little bit of motivation. I didn't get netherite, but what I did do is get a whole bunch of tools that are just ready to be turned into netherite. And you might be saying, how long could this possibly take? Well, you don't want to know. But what's good, if you guys remember the old mechanic for the fish farm, I got an absolute buttload of books. So what I did is I went over to the XP farm, which is like the ender farm, and I literally sat there for hours and hours and hours. I took all of my books, took all of the tools that I found from the end, all of those are gone, forgot to tell you, and I turned them all into perfect equipment that they're not netherite, but if I ever lose everything, I can quickly turn it into netherite. So once again, guys, this is a bit, these aren't just enchanted axes. Every single one of these is efficiency 5, unbreaking 3, plus many of them have mending, and many of them have obviously silk touch, fortune, and all that. Every single one of these has the minimum of a mining, and then also has all that other stuff. Same with the shovels here, full chest full of just efficiency 5, unbreaking 3, and then some of them have add-ons like fortune, and you know, and then same with the axes. I have a couple less axes, but yeah, all of these are perfectly good. And then swords is a little harder because I needed sharpness 5, unbreaking 3, and looting minimum on all of them, actually, and sweeping 3 minimum. And then if I could get knockback or mending, I did, but the minimum is there of those. And then some of them had fire aspect too. But yeah, so those are all my swords. And obviously you guys know I didn't forget about my armor here. I did a lot with the armor, so I went through every single one of these armor sets and took out everything that wasn't mending. So, and then obviously I did enchant all the new ones. I made them perfect armors. And so every single one of these, except just a couple here that I ran out of, they're fully enchanted plus mending. And you can see some of them are already netherite, mostly the chest plates because yeah, I don't use those. But yeah, all of these are perfectly armors, but that's not it. You might be wondering, there's usually only these two white ones. Where'd these come from? Well, I needed more room. Every single one of these is a perfect pant. All of these are perfect shoes, so unbreaking 3, protection 4, plus minimum of feather falling, plus another enchantment. So either Depth Strider or Frost Walking. Perfect helmets, once again, unbreaking 3, protection 4, plus both Respiration and Aqua Affinity. I think those are the only two you can get anyway, so every single one of those has those, plus mending on some of them, and then just more, even better, just good chest plates and more of the other ones. So once again, this might not seem fun or too big, but I have, if you guys are seeing, I will never, probably for the rest of my life of this series, I'll never have to go get this stuff. And I did all of this once again at the Ender Farm, and luckily there's actually some updates for the Ender Farm over there, so we're just gonna go ahead and head over there right now. So you guys know we built the Nether Hub just a little bit ago. That's looking all nice and spicy. Well, the next is the End Hub, and this one's actually, in my opinion, a little harder because this stuff is very annoying to mine. Netherrack, you just go, you know what I'm saying? This one, no, you have to go like one by one, and it's pretty blast resistant, so you can't even use TNT. I did most of this using beds, and actually, if you guys want to know where I lost that original Netherite armor, it was right here. I blew up something, and then I went, ooh, and I went, ooh, and then, yeah, I almost died. Well, actually, I didn't almost die. I did die, and I lost everything, but I started clearing it out. Obviously, I have to clear out much, much more because my bases are very big. I'm not going to make them small, you know. Oh, I didn't even see that up there. Oh, that's actually kind of not bad. I was going to say, well, I was going to block my building. Actually, that could be part of the building. It's actually kind of cool. But anyway, so I started doing work, and obviously, I'm going to be doing more. We're not going to finish it in today's episode. And for here, there's not actually any updates, except, oh, there's spare levels. But this entire thing is filled with enderpearls. I need to expand my storage because I actually ran out of space. I ended up probably wasting, if I would guess, at least like 50,000 enderpearls just up there to despawn because they're filled. And this is just like the remnants of what was left over. Just a couple of things, a couple of swords. These are basically the unenchantables. And then here I have some ready books that I can put on stuff, but I don't want to craft any more diamond equipment because I need that for cash. And I already have 20 million sets of everything, so I don't really need it either. And then lastly, I removed that map. If you guys remember, I had like the map thingy. I moved it down here just temporarily. I'm still planning on making a map room, but I moved it down here, and I also expanded the map this way because realistically, that's probably where we're gonna go next. I don't want to build into this area because it's mostly mountains, and mountains are hard to build on. So if I do anything over here, it's definitely gonna be something with like games or like, you know, a high base. So I'm not moving in towards this direction. Up high is definitely somewhere we can go. But realistically, the next frontier is this. And then I also updated all of the things, so, you know, I finally updated those to put in the 3 shelters. So yeah, if you guys want like a general overview of my base, you can take a look at it right here. This might be a little sad to say, but this is 8 years of progress. Now just imagine if I didn't stop playing Minecraft for like, you know, a couple, because I play this game in like weird cycles where I play a whole lot in 1 month, I take 3 months break, play a whole lot in another month. You know, so I play on and off, and it's been 8 years. The thing is, recently I've been playing a lot just because of college, and I don't really have time for, like, competitive games. So I kind of just jump on for, like, a half an hour at a time and, you know, work on the base. Alright, as far as what I did in the past episodes, that's kind of it. There's a few things that I do want to do. I'm just going to keep playing and kind of we'll see how it does, but I want to fight the Ender Dragon a few times. If you guys remember, we killed the Ender Dragon, 2015. I've never beaten it since. I've beat it that one time, but I know that you can respawn, and I don't know why I've never done it, so we're gonna go ahead and do that. There's a few small things. I want to add a piston hidey hole for Netherrack in the Nether. I want to expand my pumpkin melon farms. It's getting spooky season anyway, so I need more pumpkins. And then I want to finish my roller coaster. There's a few unfinished bits. And then another thing that I want to do, just because I want to make my base look cool, there's a lot. Oh yeah, so all this is obviously done, but I've got plenty more that's not. You might be wondering, why is this stuff over here? Well, all of this armor is stuff that has things like fire protection and blast protection, and I don't want to use those. I want to use my protection 4, right? So, and I can't remove, I mean, I guess I could remove the enchantment and put a new one onto there, but that's too much work, and I'd just have to re-enchant it and stuff, so what I'm going to be doing is using these as decoration. So I'm going to be placing armor stands all over my bases just with armor, you know, just to make it look cool. But anyway, it looks like my time is up. I kind of need to do some adult things nowadays. So, I'm going to stop recording here. I'm just going to go, you know, do my thing and then play some games. And then I'll kind of give you guys an update when there's something to be updated. Okay, everybody, just some random things that I've been doing. This was probably the stupidest thing I've ever done. And I don't know why it took so long to realize it. But this bamboo farm never produced anything. I thought it did, but it didn't. Because none of it had light. It was literally this little section here was the only part that grew because of the sunlight. Everything else straight up didn't grow for the past I don't even know how many episodes. And I didn't realize it because I covered it up. So I stuck a bit of light in there. I know it takes away from the, you know, the efficiency because now like there's a bunch of blocks that aren't bamboo. But this means that everything in here grows. So profit, I guess, right? Instead of it not working at all, now it works slightly lower. And then the other thing I did, I told you guys about all the extra armor that I wanted to put around town. It is now basically all dispersed around, so you can see like there's one armor there. And I kind of just put them just to kind of look cool. There's one armor there. So it's just like when I'm flying around town, I get to see some diamonds, you know. So there, I put two over there. I put one on my porch. I put four of them over here. There's one over by the village. I put two over here next to each of those. One over there. Two next to there. I put one over there. I put one right here. Yup. Alright, I think what I'm going to do next is... I think I'm going to go work on the nether tunnel a bit. I bought some end rods. And I still have some bone blocks. I might go just work on that a little bit. Quick update, I put a hole above the stairs here just so I have the option of flying, because before the only way I could fly is under these, and it was a little rough. So I added two, you know, just kind of holes above here, and obviously, and I'll just run so you guys can kind of see it. I finished all of the walls, all of the stairs, all of the ice, all of the end rods, I finished all of those, and I also moved a lot of like the entrances. So what I have to do now is just do like the pathways for right here, but I'll do that later. But I move a lot of these were like in the way right here, so I decided, you know, just to go ahead and move them. I still gotta light that portal, but as you can see, it goes all the way. And then I know this is super loud, sorry. And if you go all the way down here, yep, we're good. So the entire tunnel itself is basically done. The only way that I would need to expand upon it is if I want to go to a different biome, which I don't see what biome I would need to go to. I would just keep going, or I would go that way. All right, guys, it's a different day, new setup. I've got a green screen behind me. I've got a Zoom interview tomorrow, so getting all set up, trying to look good and stuff. But I got a little bit of time to play, and I got some plans. First, I want to expand the melon and pumpkin farms. Then I want to have a universal redstone trigger. I'll explain that once I do it. And then I want to fight the Ender Dragon a few times, like I said. So it's done. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. So this isn't technically a new farm because it's a farm that we already had, but I just expanded it. So these are the pumpkins, these are the melons, and before they were only up to like that third level here. Well, I took both of them and expanded them up pretty high. I could take them even higher, but if I put them any higher at that point, it'd be kind of like no use. It'd just be too much, and plus I don't even use these two. I just like to have a farm for them. So those are all good and done. Next, I did the universal trigger. So let me explain a little bit, because you guys might be wondering like why, what, you know, all that stuff. So Long story short, a lot of pistons going off cause lag on servers, but also just on your computer, right? And I've got this farm with a bunch of pistons. This one now has a bunch of pistons. You know, I've got the sugarcane with a bunch of pistons. These are constantly going off and slowing down my game passively, right? So here's my fix to this. I technically don't need too many of these items, especially the bamboo. I've got this farm, so like I don't technically don't even need the other one. But I still want them to be operational, right? So here's what I'm gonna do. Or what I did is I placed one button in the world that sets off all of these farms, so I can set them off whenever I want, which will cause extreme lag for 1 second, but that way I have all the lag in 1 second instead of dispersed throughout my entire game. You feel me? So I already did it. You know, I set up this one, that one, and that one. So let me go show you guys. If I go down, and this might change the location of the universal redstone trigger. But for now, I put it there just because it's a good spot to interact with everything else, you know, to link up. So it's right here. So you can see if I can either press the button or just pull the lever to keep it activated. I'm going to pull the lever for now just so I can kind of show you guys. You can see there's a lot of lag all at once. You can see my game slowing down a little bit. And now if we see, well, these ones aren't going to be triggered just because I have the one tick pulse over there. But you can see over here with these pumpkins and melons, every single piston here is triggered, and then the same with the sugar cane here. All of those are triggered. So I think this is just a really, really nice way to do this. And there's a few reasons why I want to keep lag down. Obviously, the biggest reason is just for comfort of the game. But there's also a few things that I want to do, like play with shaders sometimes, which I'll actually put on in a minute here. And it requires. Hello? Hello? Dude, what is hitting me? What? Oh, I think my Ender Pearl spawned an Endermite. I threw one a little bit ago. That's actually kind of funny. Alright, well, anyway. Yeah, I do want to play with shaders. Last thing we have to do is fight the dragon, but before we do, I just want to put on shaders for a minute just so I can kind of show you guys. The world actually looks pretty nice. Very laggy, but it looks pretty nice. So there are a few structures that look particularly good, which is the castle, the tower, and the monument, which I'll let them load for a minute, but I'll let you guys kind of take a look. It's a little off because light is very, like, concentrated in small spots, so it looks a bit weird. I think I could play with the settings, but I'm not going to do that right now because I kind of just want to show it off. But I guess first we'll show off the monument here, and that looks really cool, especially with, like, the sea lanterns being very, very glowy. You can kind of see them dispersed through there. I think that looks, this specific area right here looks pretty cool. Obviously, I love the sky and stuff. And if we go to the tower looks really, really good. I think the tower is the best looking structure in my game, especially in shaders. You can see up the top kind of looks the Empire State Building. Yeah, I think that looks so nice. And then obviously the castle's always looking real good. Let's try to, ooh, there we go. Yeah, then the castle's always looking good. Yeah, I guess I'll just give a little. Let's go on the road, actually. And actually, this farm looks pretty good here too. Those look really nice. But yeah, I know you guys haven't ever seen shaders on my world, at least. And if you wonder what it looks like, this is what it. Ooh, there's a creeper. And then this is what the inside of my base looks like. Pretty cool. You know something that I haven't me ever looked at? I've never looked at the Nether with shaders on, actually. This will be new to me too. Ooh, need to let it load. Okay. This definitely looks a little bit more like a hangar with the whole light aspect of it. It actually looks really nice. But yeah. Alright guys, last thing we're gonna do today is gonna go fight the dragon, and full transparency, I technically like already recorded it, so I'm gonna be wearing different stuff, completely different setup, but that's gonna be the last thing we do today. Okay, let's do this for the first time in 5 years. Place one there. Place one here. Place one here. And I think if I place a fourth one here. Oh, he is. Oh, and is it gonna respawn all of them? Oh, and it killed the Enderman. And then when it respawns all of them, I'm gonna go ahead and guess that the Ender Dragon itself gets respawned. There he is. Okay, well, I know. know how to fight the Ender Dragon. I didn't lose that much, so we're gonna go ahead and bam, bam, bam. Ooh, am I dreaming? I thought I was gonna go like dream status right there. That's fine. Okay, now we gotta get inside some of these. Oop, wrong. Wrong tool there. Oh no, I missed it. Alright, well, I guess I can try to. Go around here. Yes, there we go. Did I miss any of them? No, I think that's all of them. Okay, well, I might actually just take the fight to the dragon. Ooh, apparently I can't do that. Okay, well, you know what? I'll just chase you down. Since we are fighting the dragon with Elytra. This is kind of like a unique fight where I don't have to like wait for him, I can literally fly at him. I don't gotta tolerate his flying shenanigans. I actually died. What killed me? I need to watch out for, like, accidentally flying into him. Wonder, does a new bedrock thing generate? Oh, there's a new one. Yeah, see, we got that one, and then we got a new one here. So we should be getting new ones. I wonder, that second time that I defeated him, where did that one go? Was it? Messed it up. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed today's episode. We did quite a lot. This was definitely like a couple days episode. But guys, as always, thanks for watching. If you did enjoy, make sure to like and comment, as it supports my channel. And I'll see you guys later. God bless, and goodbye.